And of course, because I created that website that I showed you some streams ago, for the IBrowse, you can visit Twitch and check for website for streamers that are doing retro stream right now, and you can select someone, let's say him, the stream, and AIO streams, the scripts that I talked to you about before, and you can have the streamer streaming on your desktop.
That's a good spot to do it in. Yeah, we have one continue again.
And also,
that just kind of works.
Right now we stream on 480p, for example. So it is pretty fine. And also, if you want to go and see, let's see if we have someone that streams Amiga or something. Let's see if Hits is streaming. Yeah, Hits is streaming. Let's view the stream. So we have a Hit streaming here. Okay, and then you can use Wookiechat, which is an IRC application, and connect to Twitch. And then come here and say join Hits, and you are in the chat room with Hits, or go and say join Volcaro GR, my chat here, and say hello guys, and I believe that is going to appear on your screen. Otherwise, hello everyone. And you can use it to communicate on Twitch while you watch the stream.
Dane, I think it was.
Livelo says, how to change window size position of Odyssey when it opens first time? I messed around the con, but it just don't work for me. Is it possible? Yeah, Livelo, it is possible, I think. I can show you in a second where we are going to open and work with Odyssey. SLD Snake says, nice, so I could watch Volcaro GR streams on OS 4.1. Awesome, yeah, you can do that. Actually, for the to connect the Wookiechat with the Twitch streams, you need to get one token code to do that. Let me remember. If you go to a search engine and write Twitch IRC guide, then you are going to see, let me use the NetSurf for that. There is a guide of the the first one that shows up here. You see that this guide comes from the official website of Twitch. So it's something that is totally safe to do it. And if you go scroll down here, it says to quickly get a token for your account, use this URL. And it opens a website which is twitchapps.com/TMI. Of course, that website uses a lot of JavaScript, unfortunately. So you have to do it on a browser that supports it. On AmigaOS 4.1, unfortunately, it doesn't work on any browser. So you have to do it on your PC or somewhere else, or even on your mobile. And then it gives you an alphanumeric, a big alphanumeric that starts with token colon something. All of that, you take all of that and you create a server on Wookiechat. Let me show you where. Select services, servers. Yeah, you create a server on Wookiechat with your Twitch username at the top and the username here, and then server name IRC chat twitch.tv, like that. And at the server password, you put the token that you got from the website of Twitch. So you have here at the top, the username should be your Twitch username. You use the irc.sat.twitch.tv as a URL for the server name, and then the server password is that token alphanumeric. And after that, when you connect, you have to join the Twitch that you want to talk to, like I did before, join hash and the name of the channel, and you are in and you can talk with them. But have in mind that I think that now I mean hello everyone on chat. When you connect with you see on your chat that I sent that message, so it works. So whenever you send any message, I can see it here, but you don't see who participates on that chat, because Twitch doesn't send that information. Either for applications that I have for Windows, the chat that I'm using on Windows, that is a Java application that does exactly that, to communicate with people on Twitch, it doesn't show you the names as soon as they start talking and start writing something on chat. So this is something that the server of Twitch does. Falcon Level says it's a good configurate. Okay, yeah. Livelord, nice, next time. Yeah, Livelord, next time you do that and tell me how it works for you. Which app you use in iBrowse for stream link? What I'm using is a package of scripts that I created. You can find them on OS 40 pod. They are called AIO streams. These ones. These are Python scripts which you can use on your system, and also have support YouTube and other websites, media websites. So, and when you do that, you can create a link on your settings of iBrowse. If you go to to GUI and Fab menus, you can set on a link. For example, I have here a new section, and then I have Play Twitch, and I call the specific Python scripts. And this way I can use that website AIO streams .amiga-projects.net as, let's say, a front end for those scripts. But this is working only for Twitch. So if you have, let's say, if you are looking for Amiga Bill streams, that now he's doesn't stream, but you can see here the channel videos, the previous videos of that he did from the previous streams, and you can select one, right click on your mouse, play Twitch, and this video is going to start playing on my screen. Right now this is 480p, because that's the resolution that I have as a default for my machine here. And also, if you don't want to do that from the iBrowse, you can do it with these scripts from the terminal, from the shell. Hello, Aris Amiga, welcome to the stream. So this is a good way to experience Twitch on AmigaOS 4. And to be honest, this is much faster because it doesn't use a lot of CPU process. Depending, of course, the graphics card that you have, because with the latest drivers for Radeon, if you have Radeon Polaris, they have a video acceleration support, so all the work is done on the graphics card. Next one that I would like to show you.